Good afternoon, children. Have a nice day. Welcome to Standard 7 Science Online Class. I hope all are safe and fine at home by the grace of God. Children, this is your Unit 5, Reproduction and Modification in Plants. So already we have learned, children, modification of roots. And root for storage, example, radish, beetroot and carrot. And mechanical support also we have learned, children, prop roots and stilt root. And today we are going to learn climbing roots. Okay, you see the betel leaves, children? Yeah. So this is the best example of climbing roots. And you see the black paper, children, notes or internodes, bear roots, which helps to the climbing. See this beautiful picture, children? Yeah, betel leaf. Next. And see here, children, do you know? So a root growing from a location other than the underground. Such a form of stem or leaf is called adventitious roots. This is called it as adventitious roots. Which one is adventitious roots, children? You know, stilt root. Yeah, sugar cane. This is one of the example of adventitious roots. And next we are going to learn gaseous exchange. You know, children, gaseous exchange means we have to take a oxygen and have to give the carbon dioxide to the plants. Yes or no? Yes. And see the plant tree name, children, Avicennia. Okay, is a tree which grows in mangroves or swamps. They are roots which are seen above the ground for the purpose of only gaseous exchange. And these types of roots are erect and pig-like. See this diagram, children. Yeah, this is the Avicennia tree. Okay, so this is a very beautiful tree, children. Yeah, it looks like a parrot. Okay, and the structures with a numerous pores through which are air circulates. Okay, these roots are called the breathing roots or nematophores. Be silent, children. Nematophores. This is clear to you, children? Yeah, this is Avicennia tree. Okay, breathing roots. And see the Vanda tree, children. Yeah, see this picture. Yeah, this is the Vanda tree. Here this Vanda is a epiphytic plant. Okay, Vanda is a epiphytic plant which grows on trees. The velamen tissues present in the epiphytic roots. Here they absorb the moisture and to perform the photosynthesis. That is the main process of this Vanda tree. Okay, will support to the other plants, other trees. Is this clear to you, children? Yes. And next we are going to learn roots for other vital functions. You know, children, sucking roots? Yeah, the roots may also perform the special functions. That is a Hestoria. Okay, our sucking roots, they are one such example. The best example is Cuscuta. You see the Cuscuta plant, children? Yeah, Cuscuta, a parasite plant. They climb the trees and other vegetations and use the historical roots, okay, and to penetrate the tissues to host plant and suck their nutrients from them. So they are usually found in parasitic plants. Okay, they are depend on a host plant for nutrients. This is clear to you, children? Yeah, see the Cuscuta plant, children. Yeah, this is the Cuscuta plant. Okay, so they will depend upon the sucking roots. Example of sucking roots, what? Cuscuta plants. See this picture, children? Yeah, very nice picture. And next we are going to learn modification of stem. Children, you see, can you guess what is the common between ginger, onion bulb and potatoes, children? Yes, all trees are stem. You see the ginger, children? Yeah. So onion, yeah, potatoes, so all our trees are what? It's only stem, not root. Okay, some plants have their stems modified for storing the food and for only vegetative propagation. Here the modified stem may be aerial roots or subaerial roots or the underground stem. Now let's learn the stems. Okay, here aerial stems and a subaerial stem or underground stem. This is clear, children? Yeah. So now let's see aerial modification. and aerial modification. You see the dry climate, children? Yeah, pyroclay, okay? And in dry climate, conserving water is a challenge. And water evaporates from the surface. You see the dry places, children? Yeah, the surface areas is larger, the evaporation would be more, you know? Yes, the surface area is always smaller. And here the evaporation will be less. There plants with male leaves have more surface area. You see the cactus plants, children? Yeah, has a thick stem and does not most food production. See the plant, children? Yeah, this is the cactus plants, children. Yeah, their evaporation will be very less. Here the plants with many leaves have more surface area here. And cactus have a thick stem. See the picture, children? It's a very thick stem. And here, see here. See here, children? Yeah, very thick stem here. Now, and here, which does not most food production through the photosynthesis, okay? And leaves are reduced to small spines with a less surface area. This is clear to you, children? Yes. And now here, next we are going to subaerial modification. Subaerial modification is nothing but this type of stems of some plants remains subaerial modification. So that means it will grow horizontally, okay, on the surface of the soil for the purpose of reproduction. This is clear to you, children? Yes. There are four types, children. One is runner. Here, you know, you see the plant, children? Yeah, very beautiful plant. The stem which grows laterally, okay, on the surface of the soil. And here, the breaks of the produced roots where it stretches the ground to give rise to a new plant. And example is centella, okay? So, that is a scientific name, children, centella. And that means, in Tamil word, that we are using vallarai, okay, vallarai. You see the plant, children, we are using this vallarai. Yeah, that is a brain development, okay. We are taking this type of greens, they are brain development. This is clear to you, children? Yes. Next, we are going to learn stolon. And here, this type of stem is a stellar and branch of the stem. This grows upwards to some distance. They are bent towards the ground. Yeah. And upon touches the ground, gives rise to a new plant. Children, this is the best example. Yeah, strawberry, wild strawberry. How many of you like strawberry? Yeah, I'm also like strawberry. See this picture, children? Yeah, stolon means runner, okay? The roots are there, producing to one place to the other places. And short stems, see the next one grown? And see the fruits, children, see the flowers? And see the next daughter plants, children? Yeah. So, the see the roots, children? Yeah. So, this is the best example of what? Stolon. This is clear to you, children? Yes. Next, we are going to the last, third one is sucker. Okay, sucker. Sucker means, you see the short and weak lateral branch, the deer grows diagonally upwards. And directly gives rise to a new shoot. Example, chrysanthemum. Okay. You see the diagram, children, chrysanthemum? Yeah. See here. Okay, children, see this picture? Yeah, this is a picture of what? Chrysanthemum. Okay. And here they are suckering short and weak lateral branch that grows in diagonally. Okay, and see the next one, children. Offset. Okay, what is offset? So offset is a short and a thick branch that arises from the actual part of the leaves. So this diagram, children, very beautiful diagram, you know. Yeah, here the axial part of the leaf, here it has a thick internodes here, okay, and it produces a turf of leaves and cluster of small roots below. Example, Echornia. This plant name what? Echornia. See the violet colored flower, children? Yeah. So next we are going to learn very very important topic, children. It's a 5-mark question, children. Underground modification. Now in aerial and subaerial modification, stem has a indefinite growth, you know already. Yeah. So in underground modified stem, whole stem is buried under the ground and definite the growth, already you know. So you see, usually stem grows above the ground, but there are some stems, they are grow under the ground to store a food. Okay, these underground stems fell and become very thick. There are four types of underground stem, children. So what are the four types? One is rhizome, next one is corm, third one is tuber, fourth one is pulp. So these are the four important underground stem. Now let's see one by one. Rhizome, okay. So here it is an underground thick stem with nodes and internodes with scale leaves at the nodes. See the diagram, children. You see example of ginger. You see the ginger and turmeric. Yeah, this is the best example of nodes and internodes for the other places. Okay, they are grows horizontally only. Okay, and an important thing, it has an irregular shape. Okay. Yeah, rhizome has buds, it gives rise to a new stem and leaves. Okay, so example of ginger and turmeric. Okay, rhizome over, children. Next, let's move for the corm. Okay, corm. Here you see this corm, children. Yeah, you are using this. I think sometimes they are telling same karanga. Yes, Colocasia family. Okay, example Colocasia. Here this underground stem is round in shape. Which shape, children? Yeah, round in shape and flat at the top and bottom. It condensed form of rhizomes and bears one or more buds in actual scale of the leaves. See this picture, children. The daughter plants rises from their buds. Example Colocasia. Okay, this is clear to you, children? Yes. And next we are going to learn tuber. Okay, tuber. And you see, children, how many of you like tuber? Example potato. Yeah, all of you like potato, children. Yeah, potato fry. Yeah, so it is enlarged and spherical underground stem. See the diagram, children. It's very nice diagram. Yeah, and they are stored the food and has many dormant buds, children. Yeah, on its surface known as eyes. If you plant a part of tuber with a bud, it grows into a new plant. I think yes or no? Yes. Example potato. And next one is bulb. Okay, bulb is nothing but onion. Okay, here it is a condensed stem which is a disc like and store the food in fleshy leaves. Their bulb has two types of leaves. One is called fleshy leaves, another one is called scaly leaves. Okay, there are two types of leaves. The upper part of the stem has a terminal buds. It covers many scaly leaves. And you see the inner fleshy leaves, they store food in your scene. That means example is garlic and onion. Okay, and see this onion picture, children. White onion, children. Okay, yeah, that is a medicinal thing. Okay, we are using white onion. That is a very large amount of medicinal properties they are present here. Okay, fine. And this 5 marks over, children. And we are going to learn the next one. Modification of leaf. And this is your last topic, children. Here the plants have changed themselves to adapt themselves in your environments to grow. Okay, children, I'll complete this topic. Okay, so next class I will discuss the modification of leaf, children. Okay, today's class is over, children. I'll give you some question answers, children. Learn and write the question answers in your classwork note, children. Already I'll give you the Roman letter 5. Okay, answer very briefly. 7 questions already given. And Roman letter 6 also I'll give you, children. Roman letter 7 answer in detail. First question also already I'll give you. Okay, and second one only I'll give you today. explain the underground stem. Okay, so learn and write clearly in your classwork note, children. Already I'll give you the 1 marks, children. Again also we have to recall the 1 marks, children. Complete your assignment, report a task completed message in this group without fail. Thank you, children. God bless you.